All right, so let me show you how sensorineural hearing loss works and how it affects you. So we start off with a normal audiogram, as you can see here. As you can see, there is 0 decibels of hearing loss across all frequencies. This is why you're able to hear me very clearly. You're able to hear all the consonants and all the words in my speech because there's no hearing loss at any frequency. Now, if you start to expose yourself to some loud noise, maybe not a lot, but just enough to cause a slight bit of damage, you will start to experience slight hearing loss. I'm simulating here a 4,000 hertz, 10 decibel reduction. It could be 3,000 hertz, it could be 6,000 hertz, it could vary depending on person to person, but very commonly it falls around the 4,000 hertz range, and you'll start to hear something like this at a slight 10 decibel hearing loss. Now, as you continue to expose yourself to loud noise, this will get worse. You'll start to fall into what is called a mild hearing loss. Now, there's nothing mild about this. Yes, they term it mild hearing loss because it can be much worse. However, the effects of it are quite severe. As you can see here, there's a 30 decibel reduction at the 4,000 hertz range. And although it's only a 30 decibel reduction, it's definitely enough to affect the quality of the speech. As you can tell, what I'm saying sounds a lot more muddy. It's not quite as crisp and clear as it was before. And in a noisy situation, it would be much more hard to understand what I'm saying. Now, if you continue to expose yourself to loud noise, of course, this is only going to get worse. The dip at the 4,000 hertz range is going to dip even further down. We're simulating a 50 decibel reduction here at the 4,000 hertz range. As you can also tell by the graph, the reduction is starting to spread into the other frequencies around it, too, causing you to lose hearing in all frequencies, just more particularly at the 4,000 hertz range. At this moderate hearing loss level, speech is becoming harder to understand, and you're having to focus more on what I'm saying. You can probably still understand me, but it's not as easy as it was, and you definitely have to focus hard. This can get very tiring throughout the day, and in noisy situations, it's getting to be almost impossible to understand speech. If we continue to increase the hearing loss to 70 decibels at 4,000 hertz, we fall into what's known as severe hearing loss. At this point, speech is almost intangible. What you do hear is mostly vowels. There's hardly any consonants in what you're listening to because most of those consonants fall around the 4,000 hertz range. And if you have a lot of loss at that range, you're not going to hear those consonants, and you're mostly going to hear vowels. So speech is going to sound really mumbly and really muffled and extremely difficult to understand. Unfortunately, this can get worse if you keep exposing yourself to extremely loud noise. Eventually, you're going to fall into what is known as profound hearing loss. This is at a 90 decibel reduction at 4,000 hertz. You can barely understand anything I'm saying. It's mostly mumbling because you pretty much aren't hearing much of anything except for the low tone vowels. This is not ideal by any means. It's almost impossible to carry on a normal conversation this way. You'll have to shout or speak very loudly to be able to understand people at this type of hearing loss. Hearing aids are almost a necessity well before this. So don't ever let your hearing progress to this level. Never. Because once it gets down to this level, there's no turning back.